He's the CEO of the Moscow City Telephone Network, and we are absolutely delighted to have him here with us today. Andrei Ershov, welcome. Thank you for your time, sir. So you're known for us as being a CEO that gets results. What do you think is the difference between sort of a world-class CEO and an average CEO? What is it that you do, for example, differently?
I find that people who are the best in their area, marketing, sales, technical, that people are the best. But my purpose to find that people through market.
Yeah. See, Ronan Dunn, the CEO of O2, said that he just surrounds himself with world-class team, and that's exactly what you just mentioned there.
Absolutely.
Get the best as
Absolutely.
You possibly can.
You're right.
So where do you spend your time, most of your time? Is it on innovations, with your people, on customers?
I think I cannot say that I spend all of my time being in my people or being in an innovation room, for example.
Okay.
It is, of course, combination. But I try to be involved in any kind of projects, main projects of my company, and try to be involved in the launching process of our product and services. It helps me to feel my business in the end of my fingers. That's why it helps me to be so deep, to make decisions and so fast, which we need to be the first and the best operator in market.
You mentioned quite a bit, Aswahan, before about the drive, the desire to be number one, to be the best in the marketplace. Is that a sort of an energy that you believe is really powerful for an organization to perform very well?
I think I need to describe my own approaches to establish rules of our business. It's some kind of a sports approach. First of all, when we say example for any kind of hockey team or NBA or some other associations of group teams sports, it shows us that they guys understood and understand each other so deep they don't need to say hello, you need to go to there and make something.
Yeah.
They need only to look at that site and everybody knows what they need to do.
Yeah.
That's why sports approach, I think, in a business helps to construct optimizing business processes, which will be more effective in comparison with other approaches. And the second, sport itself helps people to be in a good condition permanently during a very long period, because it's helped me to be in a good fit in a physical body. That's why if you achieve something, it doesn't mean that you will stop doing something to be the best. You should do it permanently, and only this way helps you to be on the top during a long period.
Yeah, I think that's fascinating, the whole sports metaphor and how it applies to business, because we interviewed Tom Peters and he made the point that the greatest business managers understand that it's like sports, because the sports managers know it's about the talent on the team. If you've got the best talent, you're going to win. So it's your earlier point about having the best team.
It's fantastic. I agree with them.
But as the CEO, I mean, ultimately, you're the guy that's making the decisions. So all CEOs sort of get a lot of advice, either from customers or stakeholders or your own passionate team. How do you go about making, but you're the guy that ultimately decides the course. So how do you go about making those decisions?
I think that some kind of business feeling should be inside you to prove a lot of advices, as you said. But of course, some kind of common operational meetings helps you to be more and more deep in the details of that advices and that cases. But first of all, you should feel a market. You should feel a possibility to launch a new products and new services for our subscribers. If you feel it, you will be good. you will be the best.
Yeah. Daniel Goleman wrote a book called Emotional Intelligence, and he said exactly that. And he said it's about using the brain and also intuition, because you've had many years in telecoms, so you'll, through the subconscious, you'll have a feel for what the right thing to do.
Absolutely.
The best leaders.
It is a combination between feeling and real business cases, which you need to calculate to prove your ideas.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, you're, Andre, in the telecommunications world, which is increasingly a technology play, and I know that you've obviously, now you're providing telecommunications services and at a fast pace, and you've got a great response. So let's talk about innovation for a second. How do you make sure that you're, you know, what one or two pieces of advice would you give to a company to make sure that they are constantly innovating, because companies need to do so never more than they do today?
I think the innovation is that area which helps every operators across the world to create opportunities for our subscribers, for our customers. And right now, deployed our GPON project, we have seen that subscribers sometimes could not use this or that service because it couldn't be provided by limitation from the speed of internet, access internet. And there are a lot of conversations here was connected with innovations and better testing of innovations. But we are deployed our GPONnet ready to implement it in 1 second, because as I said previously, we optimized our business processes, we automated it. We provide our customers speed more than 500 megabits today, and we're ready to increase it times in a very short period. That's why we need to know about innovations, all about innovations. Being here, it support me. And you, as I said, need to feel which kind of innovations will be really, you should feel real demand from your subscribers.
Yeah.
Because it was very interesting approach from Steve Jobs, because he hates some kind of marketing researches. He created a product which he feels that will be very interesting for subscribers, and the demand will appear.
Yeah.
The same approach from our side.
Did you ever read Steve Jobs' book?
Yeah.
Yes, and it is one of the best business book for real ordinary people, because it's so impressive, their approach which he used in his job. He was extraordinary man, and if you want to be extraordinary manager, first of all, you should be extraordinary in your lifestyle.
Yeah, excellent. What do you mean by lifestyle? In your
I mean a hobby. I mean some kind of sports exercises or something like that. Because if you don't have a hobby, if you don't have a real opportunity to achieve something, not in a business area, you will not be able to achieve a real business goals in your ordinary life.
Well, one so is sort of having passions in business and outside of business. And, and one of the things I heard in your presentation is, you know, your innovations, you're passionate about your customer base, and you're just desperate to innovate on their behalf. And it's just, I've absolutely been delighted to spend this time with you, Andre. Thank you for your time. It's been great to meet you.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you.
Thank you.